sample family introduction. Good morning, Jesse. Good morning, Mrs. X. I'm Mrs. Sutherland, and I'm here today to review with you your latest mathematics assessment. In looking at the test results, I can see that Jesse has strength in the area of numbers and operations, and that he still needs a little work in algebraic reasoning and algebra. It looks like that he has untapped potential in these areas, but that he may be lagging a little bit because of a lack of confidence. I think it'll be easy to take the facility that he has with numbers and operations and build on that to increase his overall ability in his mastery and confidence level with doing algebra problems, especially in the areas of equations and inequalities. We're going to be beginning at home and working on more foundational and fundamental skills like deconstruction of numbers and patterns, working up to our in-home one-on-one meeting where we will address actually working with real-world scenarios and equalities in equations, solving those types of problems. All right, task one, analyzing the data. I took a look at the data that was provided, and I looked through to see where his relative areas of strength and weakness were. I also noted that it was a big problem for him to get motivated and to really begin to work on tasks to solve the problems and to increase his mastery level. So looking at the data, I could see that numbers and operations and data probability were relative strengths. So it looks like that he has some facility with his math facts, and that provides some optimism for his ability to address these more difficult tasks. So looking at the various tasks that the test data indicated that he should begin working on, I looked through the ones that played to his strengths. So that would be decomposing numbers and recognizing patterns. Those would be things that he could begin to work on at home prior to the one-on-one visit. At the one-on-one visit, I targeted standard 3A21, which has to do with symbols and solving for the unknown in equations. And so I thought that would be the one that would be the best to work on in a one-on-one setting. I did some research on this topic, since math is not my strong suit, and I found a number of resources that deal with these concepts. I included those in my lesson plan as resources both for myself and for the student. Those links provide step-by-step instruction in these areas, along with videos and problems that can be worked. It would be my idea that starting with the most basic tasks is consistent with RTI principles, and then targeting the most basic but the most complex and abstract of those tasks would be the one that would be best for one-on-one instruction from the teacher. So that was my reasoning and analysis for task one. In task two, I was asked to create a lesson plan that was individualized for the student. And in doing that, I tried to be sensitive to his strengths and his weaknesses and to provide a variety of ways that those tasks could be addressed. So I have introduced the concept of building on prior knowledge first, of course, and then built in a mini lesson where we would introduce new concepts. I think it would be very important for him to have both visual and tactile materials available at that one-on-one so that we could work through a variety of problems. But ultimately, my goal is for him to be able to utilize those tasks and to those concepts and to create those kinds of things for himself. The lesson plan then goes on to provide some time where we would work together and where I would be able to assess during that one-on-one period using a menu whether or not he was able to show some mastery of the new concepts.